name's Margaret Bell, I'm one of the ministers here at this church. It is an absolute delight to welcome you all to Knox Church this evening for the Otago Girls High School Celebration Service of 2023. Knox has had a long relationship with the school, and what a pleasure for us to share in this feast of music and word and achievement that is before us tonight. May you all remember this celebration as a special moment in your lives, and may we together enjoy all that you have to offer and celebrate as individuals and as school. Now my home.
Number of people who achieve it. Miraculous result, a lot of hard Find something you want to do and learn how to do it really well. Take what you've got and make the most of it. Learn how to do something, whatever it is, you will choose to do for nothing. Whatever it is, when you're doing it, it makes you feel amazing and most yourself. Throw yourself into it. Challenge yourself to be the best you can be. We can't all be famous actors, but if you can find something you love, and if that something will also pay the bills, you'll be well on your way to your own personal paradise.
Glow, not raise theme, that sort of program.
sat together on the steps of Union Square in New York to write down how they defined success. The goal was to create something that they could reflect back on if they ever felt stuck or found themselves living according to someone else's definition of happiness. Tonight, Freya Glover, winner of the Year 9 Speech Fest, will read the definition to you. This is your life. Do what you love and do it often. If you don't like something, change it. If you don't like your job, quit. If you don't have enough time, stop watching TV. And if you are looking for the love of your life, stop. They'll be waiting for you when you start doing the things you love. Stop overanalyzing. Life is simple. All emotions are beautiful. When you eat, appreciate every last bite. Open your mind, heart, and arms to new things and people. We are united in our differences. Ask the next person you see what their passion is and share your inspiring dream with them. Travel often. Getting lost will help you find yourself. Some opportunities come only once. Seize them. Life is about the people you meet and the things you create with them. So go out and start creating. Life is short. Live your dream and share your passion.
Thank you.
time. Read to us tonight by Rana Al-Sharif, the winner of the Year 10 in Sessions.
Thank you. be mindful of the movement your body is making. Feel the movement of the foot as you lift and lower it to the ground. Feel the swing of the arms, the motions of the muscles. Feel the purpose in your walk. When you're in conversation, really listen to what the other person is saying. Be present to them and hear them. Stephen Covey, author of The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, tells us most people do not listen with the intent to understand. They listen with the intent to reply. Can you be the exception to that rule? Pause throughout your day to notice the breath. This flow of air that gives you life is the first thing you ever did when you entered this world and will be the last thing you ever do in this life. And if you are like most people, you only notice it when there is a reason you can't breathe so well. Try setting an alarm on your phone for every hour in your day, and on this hour, spend a moment taking 3 deep breaths and being fully connected to and grateful for your breath. End each day with a moment of gratitude. List at least 3 things you are grateful for in that day. When you stop and take the time to appreciate the little things in life, it is so much easier to appreciate the many gifts that you have in life, even when you might not feel that you have a lot.
Went viral in the
to be handed a cup of coffee is hot, and to say thank you to the person handing it. To smile at them, and for them to smile back. For the waitress to pull us honey as she sits down with a calm bowl of chowder. And for the driver of the red pickup truck to let us pass. We have so little of each other now, so far from tribe and fire. Only those brief moments of exchange. What if they are the true dwelling of the holy? Those fleeting temples we make together as we say, hey, I love your hat. Go ahead, you first. Here, have my seat. Like a lid of ice cream, the flavor of grace. Thank you.
In a hyper-modern society propelled by the twin engines of acceleration and excess, doing nothing is equated with waste, laziness, lack of ambition, boredom, or downtime. But this betrays a rather instrumental grasp of human existence. Much research and many spiritual and philosophical systems suggest that detaching from daily concerns and spending time in simple reflection and contemplation are essential to health, sanity, and personal growth. Similarly, to equate doing nothing with non-productivity betrays a short-sighted understanding of productivity. In fact, psychological research suggests that doing nothing is essential for creativity and innovation, and a person's seeming inactivity might actually cultivate new insights, inventions, or maladies. As legends go, Isaac Newton grasped the law of gravity sitting under an apple tree. Archimedes discovered the law of buoyancy relaxing in his bathtub, while Albert Einstein was well known for staring for hours into space in his office. The academic sabbatical is centered on the understanding that the mind needs to rest and be allowed to explore in order to germinate new ideas. Doing nothing, or just being, is as important to human well-being as doing something. The key is to balance the two. Take your foot off the pedal, since it will probably be difficult to go cold turkey from an accelerated pace of existence to doing nothing. One first step consists in decelerating. One relatively easy way to do this is to simply turn off all of the technology that connects us to the internet, at least for a while, and assess what happens to us when we do. Danish researchers found that students who disconnected from Facebook and other social media for just 1 week reported notable increases in life satisfaction and positive emotions. In another experiment, neuroscientists who went on a nature trip reported enhanced cognitive performance. As we race along, it seems as though we're not taking the time to seriously examine the rationale behind our frenetic lives and mistakenly assume that those who are very busy must be involved in important projects. Touted by the mass media and corporate culture, this credo of busyness contradicts both how most people in our society define the good life and the tenets of many Eastern philosophies that extol the virtue and power of stillness. French philosopher Albert Camus perhaps put it best when he wrote, "Idleness is fatal only to the mediocre."
the school. We would just like to firstly say a big thank you to Ms. Dick for being the person behind all of this. Celebration would not be able to happen without you, and we are incredibly grateful for all your work here over the years that we've been here. Your energy is amazing, and it really shines through on these occasions, so once again, thank you.
Just time. Hands up like the ceiling can hold us. Like the ceiling. Look around, it's me and my room.